Nowadays, part of the world is writing by developer. Typing a lot of code, we can create websites, software, video games, and so much more. So, what if this art of writing new program could be replaced by an artificial intelligence? It could be crazy. A developer creating a neural network able to code by itself, a new project just from a simple list of tasks. Okay, so let's do it. In fact, what we're gonna do is just training a recurrent neural network able to generate step by step a piece of fake code where one step will only produce a new letter. The dataset used in this project is based on the Linux kernel. So actually only C file from the Linux kernel. So I already extracted all file and you can find and download all this stuff on my GitHub repository. It is impossible for a neural network to deal with letters. Neural network can only understand numbers. This is why all letters of the dataset should be translated to numbers with one number per character. For example, I would be 11, F15, space letter 30, and so on. Okay, so let's start by extracting C file's content. So the three important variables to keep in mind here are first, vocab to int, which is a dictionary mapping all letters with the associated numbers. Then, int to vocab, a dictionary as well, which do the same things but in the other direction. So, number to letters. Finally, the encoded variables is a big vector with all letters replaced by their numbers. So now we have some first values to work with, and we want our network to be able to predict the next letter to be typed knowing the n preceding letters. So suppose we use only one letter, let's say the letter E, and we would like to predict the next one using a simple feedforward neural network. The possibilities of evolution are so huge, and I can't train a neural network only with one previous step. However, if I tell him that the last letters are W, H, I, L, and E, then it's much more obvious that the next letter will be a parenthesis. This is why we need to use a recurrent neural network. So with this in mind, let's create a simple batch of two sequences where each sequence will consist of 10 numbers. This batch is only an example used in this video. Batches are slightly different on the main project. So what we can see is that for each input, we have an associated target value, which is the next input value, since it's the value we want to predict. So we can now start creating the TensorFlow graph. So the shape expected for the input is of size 2 per 10. 2 because we have 2 sequences and 10 which is the size of each sequence. And we can define the same shape for the target. Finally, we define a placeholder for the value of the probability used for the future dropout. So this is simply a value between 0 and 1 because this is a probability. Now let's create the neural network. The createSet function is used to create an LSTM cell composed of 4 iron neurons. This function also adds dropout to the cell. Multi-RNN cell is used to easily create the RNN. We give as a parameter an array of function. Here the function is createSet. Because we want a neuron consisting of several layers, 3 in this example, each cell of the RNN depends on the previous state. So, we must create an initial state for the first time we use each cell. The tensor X1OT translates the batch into 1OT encoding format. Then, the cell output tensor gives us the output of each cell of the RNN. Here, each cell will consist of 4 values, which is the number of hidden neurons. And finally, the final state tensor returns the final state of each cell. The value of the output of the cell are stored in a 3-dimensional table of shape 2 per 10 per 4. And we no longer need to separate the outputs by sequences, so we need to resize the output to get an array of shape 20 by 4. Finally, we apply a simple linear operation, so in our case, this is just a simple feedforward operation. And the word is followed by a softmax, give us a probability for the next letter. In order to compute the loss, the targets of the batch must be of the same shape as the output values of the model. So tf.1out is used to translate the target in one-out encoding vector. Then we resize the array with tf.shape to the same dimensions of the linear output. And now we can use the cross-entropy function to compute the error of the model. And now, final step, we simply apply an ADAM optimizer to minimize the error previously computed. I think is one of the most rewarding parts, the result of the training. I have for this one used the following parameters. Now let's look at what type of code this model is able to create. It's pretty good to see that this model has clearly understood the general structure of a program, a function, parameters, initialization of variables, condition, and so on. But there is absolutely no function named superfall in the dataset, so it's hard for me to understand the usefulness of this function. Maybe I will admit that this model is perhaps more intelligent than me, or not, I don't know. So thank you for watching this video, I really hope you like it. Please comment, share, like it, and know. See you next time.